Hello everyone, it is the Math Department of Sophomore High School. This presentation is the last session of Chapter 16, Complex Numbers. Objectives of the session are 1. To define the square root of a complex number. 2. To determine the square roots of a complex number. 3. To solve equations on C. Definition of a square root. Let Z be a non-zero complex number. A complex number W is called the square root of Z if and only if W square equals to Z. Property. Any non-zero complex number has two opposite square roots. Direct example. Show that these two complex numbers are square roots of -3 + 4. I. By definition, it is enough to show that the squares of these two complex numbers will be -3 + 4i. 1 + 2i whole square. It is of the form a + b². a² + 2ab, which is 4i, plus b squared. b² 4i squared. And don't forget, I square minus 1. This is why 4i square equals to minus 4. Then the square of this complex number equals -3 + 4i. Consequently, this complex number is a square root of -3 + 4i. In a similar way, square of this complex number will be -3 + 4i. Finally, draw a conclusion. These two complex numbers are square root of -3 + 4i. How to determine the square roots of a given complex number Z equal a + ib? Technique. Let wx + iy be one of these square roots. Then by definition, W squared equal to Z. Equate to get X squared minus Y squared equal A to XY equal B. Then solve to determine the square roots. Let us start by application to explain what we are talking about. Application number 1. Find the square roots of the complex number I, part 2. Verify the obtained results by calculation. Question here, what are the numbers whose squares will be I? Applying technique, let wx + iy, of sure x and y are two real numbers, be a square root of I. By definition, W square equals to Z. Substitute wx + iy and Z by its value to get x + iy² equal I. Do expansion here. A squared, square of the second minus y squared, twice first second, 2xy I. Rewrite I as 0 + 1i. In this case, as you notice, these two complex numbers are equal if and only if real part of the first equal real part of the other, imaginary part of the first equal imaginary part of the other, which is 1. How to complete? 2xy equal 1 gives us y equal 1 over 2x. Substitute y by its value in this equation. Then this equation is transformed to this equation. Now distribute square over 1, which is 1, square over 2x, which is 4x squared, to get, take 4x squared as a common denominator. This equation becomes 4x power 4 minus 1 equal to 0. Of sure x different from 0. Pay attention to me. Why x cannot be 0? Simply because product xy equal half, then the product xy cannot be 0. This is why any one of these two real numbers cannot be 0. Let us complete. For x to the power 4 minus 1 will be 0. Now apply a minus b, a plus b equal to 0. Product equal to 0. And this real number is a positive real number. Then just 2x squared minus 1 will be 0. To complete, isolate x squared equal half, x equal plus or minus 1 over radical 2. Multiply up and down by radical 2 to get x equal plus or minus radical 2 over 2. As you see, x has two values, but x and y are related by this relation. This is why to each value of x, there exists a unique value of y. Case number 1. For x equal minus radical 2 over 2, make a substitution in this relation, 2 and 2 carry out, to get this final answer. Then w1 equal x plus iy equal minus radical 2 over 2 into 1 plus radical 2 is one of the square roots. Let us find the second square root. Case 2. For x equal radical 2 over 2, then y will be radical 2 over 2. Then we name the second square root w2. Why I name w1 and w2? Simply to distinguish between them. Then w2 equal radical 2 over 2 into 1 plus I. In this case, the two square roots of I are W1 and W2. Now go to part 2. Verify the obtained results by calculation. What is required is to show that W1 and W2 are square roots. It is enough to show that W1 square equal I. Let us start. W1 square, square of this component. Now distribute the square over the first and over the second. Do calculations to get I, and consequently W1 is a square root of I. In a similar way, W2 square equal I. And finally, a conclusion, W1 and W2 are square roots of I. Application number 2. Let f of z equal z squared minus 4 plus 5 I into z plus 7 I minus 1. Part 1. Calculate the square roots of the complex number minus 5 plus 12 I to solve the equation f of z equal to 0. Let us start by solution. As I said before, we should find two complex numbers whose squares will be minus 5 plus 12 I. Let W equal x plus iy, of sure x and y are real numbers, to be a square root of minus 5 plus 12 I. By definition, W square equal to z. Make a substitution, WY its value. Do calculations, we reach this result. Now these two complex numbers are equal. This occurs in the case real part equal to real part and imaginary part equal to imaginary part. Second equation, 2xy equal 12 will give us y equal 6 over x. Substitute y in the first equation, then the equation becomes, instead of y 6 over x, it becomes 6 over x squared. Now square of 6, that is 6 of x, x squared, to get, now take x squared, a common denominator, then x power 4 minus 36 over x squared will be minus 5, of sure x different from 0. Criss-cross method, now group all terms to the first side. This type of equation is called a bi-quadratic equation. It is studied in the first semester. Technique of solving, let t equal x squared, of sure, greater than or equal to 0. The equation under this condition could be transformed into t squared plus 5t minus 36 equal to 0. Since use of calculator is allowed, use a calculator to get the roots are t minus 9, t equal 5. Or you may calculate delta, then find the roots. We have same result. Now, don't forget t equal x squared and t equal 4. We are not finished yet. We must find x and y to determine w. Let us go to the next slide. Tx squared and t4, this gives that x squared equal 4, and consequently x will be plus or minus 2. Don't forget this condition, y equals 6 over x. To each value of x, there exists a unique value of y. Let us calculate the values of y. Case number 1. X minus 1, y minus 3, then w1, minus 2 minus 3i. What about second case? Substitute x equal 2 in this equation to get y3, and so w2 equal 2 plus 3i. As you notice, these two square roots are opposite. Draw a conclusion. This complex number has two square roots that are 2 plus 3i and minus 2 minus 3i. Part 2. Solve f of z equal to 0. Of sure, f of z equal to 0, it is clear that this equation will be 0. Now, it is a quadratic equation of complex coefficients a1, b coefficient of z, which is minus into 4 plus 5i, and c 7i minus 1. To solve this equation, we should compute its discriminant, delta equal b squared minus 4ac. After performing calculations, delta will be minus 5 plus 12i. And don't forget, minus 2 minus 3 squared, 2 plus 3 squared equal minus 5 plus 12i, which is delta in this case. Delta equal minus 5 plus 12i, which is either square of this complex number or square of this complex number. First choice, we may choose delta to be 2 plus 3i. Then radical delta will be 2 plus 3i. Now compute the roots. Z1 minus b minus radical delta over 2a. Do calculations to get 1 plus i. Of sure, z2 minus b plus delta over 2a. Complete to get 3 plus 4i. Some students may choose delta to be minus 2 minus 3i. Second choice, delta, choose it to be minus 2 minus 3i squared. The radical delta will be minus 2 minus 3i. Compute again the roots to get 3 plus 4i, 1 plus i. As you notice, in both cases, delta has two choices, but in both cases, the roots are the same. This is why from now on, use just one value of delta. Choose delta, either this value or that value. Let us complete. Application number 3. Solving the equation. Before I solve this equation, it is of fourth degree. This is that this equation should admit four roots in C. Now, let us start by solution. Z4 minus 16 equal to 0. Apply the identity. A squared minus B, A squared plus B equal to 0. Product equal to 0. Then the first term equal to 0 or the second will be 0. What about this equation? It is clear that the square minus 4 equal to 0. Then z square 4 and a final result z equal plus or minus 2. What about this equation? Z squared plus 4 equal to 0. Then z square will be minus 4. Now to get rid of minus, we rewrite minus 4 as 4i squared and consequently z plus or minus radical and the value of radical plus or minus 2i. Finally, this equation has four roots. The set solution are minus 2, 2 that are real complex number, minus 2i plus 2i that are pure imaginary. Pay attention to me. If I solve this equation not in C, in R, this equation z squared plus 4 equal to 0 does not have a root simply because there is no real number whose square will be minus 4. There is a difference between solving in C and solving in R. Let us complete. A, B, C, D be the point images of the obtained root. Plot A, B, C, D in the complex plane and show that they form a square. Let ZA equal minus 2. Rewrite it minus 2 plus 0i, then A has coordinates minus 2, 0. You may choose ZA equal 2, you may choose ZA equal minus 2i. There is no difference between ZB equal 2, then B to 0, ZC minus 2i. Then C will be 0 minus 2 and similarly D will be 0, 2. Now plot the 4 points ABCD in a complex plane. As you see, A minus 2, 0, B 2, 0, C 0 minus 2, D 0, 2. Now what is the nature of this quadrilateral? The diagonals AB and DC are perpendicular and equals and bisect each other. This is why this square ACBD form a square. Let us complete the last application. Application number 4. And see, given the equation for z minus 3i, z bar equal minus 2i plus 5i. We aim to solve this equation. The main objective is to find z. For this reason, let z equal x plus iy. Of sure, x and y are real. It is the answer key. Then z bar x minus iy. In order to complete, substitute z and z bar by their values in a given complex equation to get. Now, multiply 4 by all minus 3i by all to get. Now, group real parts alone and imaginary parts alone. Of sure, take I a common factor. In this case, these two complex numbers are equal. It occurs in which case if real part of the first equal to real of the other, and imaginary part of the first equal imaginary of the other. Now we have a system of two unknowns that can be solved easily. Let us complete. I rewrite this equation minus 3y plus 4x minus 2. Now multiply the first by 4, the second by 3, and this method, of course, is called elimination method. Add to get 7x7 and so x equal 1. Now substitute x in either 1 or in 2. Substitute in second to get 4y minus 3 equal 5. So y equal 2. Then x and y are 1 and 2. It's not the final answer. Substitute x and y in z. Consequently, z1 plus 2i is the only solution of this equation. At the end of this session, I advise you to pause the video through each application and try to solve on your own. Thanks for your listening.